Shalom, 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 wakazak mashpaka. Welcome to another episode of Script Unveiled, right here on GC Creativity. And I'm that same humble host of yours, DGN Yasharala. And like you all know, that on Script Unveiled, we are always here to look into the matters that the awakening nation of Yasharal are not paying attention to, so that we can be able to go back to the drawing board and get ourselves right. But before we go on to this episode of the program, let us go on a quick commercial break, as we'll be right back. Don't go nowhere. It's still your program, Script Unveiled, right here on GC Creativity.
For sponsorship, advert placement, please call or WhatsApp this number,
Welcome back from that short commercial break. It's still your program, Script Unveiled, and I remain your same host, DGN Yasharala. Like you all know, that on this program, the first thing we acknowledge first is the Most High Yah. So let us all face the East and send prayers unto Yahuwah. But Yahuwah, we say thank you. We thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for the gift of health. We thank you for our trials and our tribulation. We thank you for our blessings and our sufferings. We thank you for your judgment. We thank you for the destruction, the condemnation to come. We thank you for the awakening nation. We thank you for the chosen ones. We thank you for those who are called, that will be cut off from among the awakening nations. Abba, it's not by our power, it's not by our mind, but it's by your Ruach HaKodesh, Abba. We say, call halalo Yahuwah to your name. Yahuwah, we pray this day. In any way that I have sinned against you, through our thoughts, through our character, through our behavior, through the words of our mouth, Abba, we pray that forgive us all our sins. And as we are coming before you this day to share your word with the people, Abba, we pray that you open the hearts of your saints. Let them hear your word and let the word have effect in them. Through your son, Yahusha Mashiach, we pray this day. So be it, and it is so. Hallelujah. Welcome back to the show. It's still your program, Script Unveiled, right here on GC Creativity. And without wasting much time, let us go into the class properly. Now, the title of today's class is titled, You Are Not Above Temptation. Stop Being Prideful. You are not above temptation. Stop being prideful. Now, why actually am I saying this? You know, the matter is, we have a lot of Israelites out there who claim to be awakened, but now I will say they turned themselves into a spoiled child, a child that know that because my father loves me, now the child started misbehaving. That misbehavior actually is the reason why they are being prideful today. So without wasting much time, let us dive into the scriptures. The book of Sirach, chapter 2, I'll take verse 1 and verse 5, and it says, My son, if you come to serve Yahuwah, prepare your soul for temptation. Can you see that? It says, My son, if you come to serve Yahuwah, prepare your soul for temptation. So how will you claim to say that you are in the truth? How can you claim to say that you are here to serve Yahuwah, and you think that you are above temptation? If Yahusha Mashiach, who is the Messiah of the nation of Yasharal, if Yahusha Mashiach can walk this earth And for the fact that he walked this earth, he was tempted by Satan. How he took him to the topmost part of the earth, showing him the earth and asking Yahusha Mashiach to bow down to him so that he can give the world to him. Or is it about how he tempted Yahusha Mashiach, since he's just fasting and he's about to end his fasting, that he should turn stone into bread? Or how about the temptation of how he was asking Yahusha Mashiach to jump from the cliff, that since he's powerful, that he can call down the angels to cast their wings to protect him? All these temptations actually is to prove to you that truly, if Yahusha Mashiach can be tempted, what make you think your many years in the truth has make you to be saved from temptation?
Sponsorship, advert placement. Please call or WhatsApp this number +234 811 731 0928.
So, if Yahusha Mashiach can be tempted, what make you think that you are above temptation? But yet we have some Hebrews that they are so prideful, will be like, I got the fire of Yahuwah in me. I'm above temptation. Satan cannot come close to me. I don't see any sign of maturity in them, because if Yahusha Mashiach can also face the temptation of Satan and deal with it, why can't Yahusha Mashiach always say that I am the Messiah? Satan, you have no right to tempt me. Remember that Satan used different methods to tempt Yahusha Mashiach. He used the Pharisees, he used the Sadducees. He used. But Yahusha Mashiach was like, I know it's your handwork, but we want to overcome it with wisdom. Look at verse 5, Sirach 2 verse 5. He says, For gold is tried in the fire, and acceptable men in the furnace of adversity. So that means truly, if you want to be an acceptable man unto Yahuwah, you will go to the furnace of adversity. So what make you think that you are above adversity, that you are above temptation? What make you think you are like that? Let's press further. Proverbs chapter 3. Mishle, Proverbs chapter 3. And now take from verse 5 down to verse 8. And it says, trust in El Yahuwah with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all things, in all your ways, pardon me, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Be not wise in your own eyes. Fear Yahuwah and depart from evil. I take that again. Be not wise in your own eyes. Fear Yahuwah and depart from evil. So now here is it. Why did King Solomon himself said that we should not be wise in our own eyes? Because at some point we think, because you have been doing things, yes, I am saved by Yah, Satan cannot get this, Satan cannot get that. Don't think you are wise in your own conceit. Instead, fear Yahuwah. Because truth be told, if you think you are above temptation, if you think you are wise at your own eye, and you don't say that you fear Yahuwah and let Yahuwah lead you, once Yahuwah chose to withdraw himself from you, you are done for. Once Yah chose to withdraw himself from a man, after the man have messed up on some things, then forget about it, you are done for. Zechariah chapter 13, pardon me. Zechariah chapter 13. And I'll take verse 8 and verse 9. He says, and it shall come to pass that in all the land, says Yahuwah, two parts therein shall be cut off and die, and the third part shall be left therein. Do you know why? Verse 9. And I will bring that third part through the fire, and will refine them as gold is refined, and will try them as gold is tried. They shall call on my name, and I will hear them. I will say, it is my people, and they shall say, Yahuwah Elohai. Why do you think he said that that third part shall be left therein? He said, for that, he said, he will bring them through the fire. What's that fire? Temptation. Sirach chapter 1 verse 2, chapter 2 verse 1 said earlier, if you come to serve me, prepare yourself for temptation. So if Yah said that he will preserve those two parts to pass through fires, talking about that he will make them go through temptations to check if truly they are diligent unto him. But yet we have a lot of Hebrews who are out there that think that it is all by their own power. Forget about it. The first day you chose to allow pride set in, Yahweh actually have removed his hand off your case. So the first day that he chose to allow pride set in into you, he has counted you to be among those two parts that be cut off and die. Why? Because you choose not to fear him anymore. He says, be not wise in your own eyes, but fear Yahuwah. So now that I think you are wise in your own eye and you refuse to fear Yahuwah, Yahuwah will choose to remove his hands. He will choose to withdraw from you and let you be all alone. You end up now becoming like a shooting stone. When you are a shooting stone, actually, you remember that when you shoot a stone up, it will be going at a very immense power due to the force from the catapult. But once that power and the force that is driving it is finished, the stone will remain powerless. Automatically, when the stone will land back, the stone will return back with double the force that pushed it forward. So that is why most times people think, because they are still prospering in their pride, they think they are doing fine. Their level of fall is coming soon. In short, it is very near. Will you wait until you fall before you get your mind right and stop being prideful to the Most High? Yeah? The book of Sirach, Ecclesiastes chapter 10. I'll take verse 7. And it says, pride is hateful, pride is hateful before Elohim and man, and by both does one commit iniquity. Christ has said that truly pride actually is the problem. He said pride actually is hateful before Yahuwah and even hateful before man. Why do you think you as a mortal human, why you chose to help somebody today and refuse to tell you thank you? Instead, the person became so prideful to you. Even you as a mortal man will choose never to help the person anymore. How much more the Most High himself? When you try to do things as if it's all by your power, the Most High will choose to withdraw all his help, withdraw his grace, withdraw his ruach, withdraw everything that's given to you and leave you empty. Why? Because pride is hateful unto before Yahuwah. Look at verse 12 and verse 13. It says, the beginning of pride is when one departs from Elohim and his heart is turned away from his maker. 13. For pride is the beginning of sin. For pride is the beginning of sin. And he that has it shall pour out abomination. He that has pride shall pour out abomination. And therefore, Yahuwah brought upon them strange calamities and overthrew them utterly. Which means when you allow pride set in, pride will set in and become sin into your life. And you that have allowed pride to set in into your life, what is left? Sometimes these are the things I do tell people that they need to really be careful about. Don't allow pride make you lose your value before the Most High. If you go down to verse 21 of that same chapter, Sirach chapter 10 verse 21, it says, the fear of Yahuwah goes before the obtaining of authority, but roughness and pride is the losing thereof. Which means, according to that scripture, it says, when you fear Yahuwah, it will go before you ahead of time for the time of when we obtain authority, which is going into Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1 and verse 2, when we will become the one to oppress the oppressor. That can only happen when we fear Yahuwah. But he said, but roughness and pride is the losing thereof, which means when you allow pride and roughness come into your life, the authority that you are meant to get to become the oppressor to the oppressors, instead of you to get that particular authority, the reverse will be the case. Why? Because you end up getting cut off. You will never get that authority simply because of you allow pride to set into your life. So why can't you work towards cutting down, stopping this prideful speech, prideful behaviors that's among our nation? The book of Yaakov, chapter 1, I'll take verse 2 through verse 4. And it says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. Verse 3, knowing this, that the trying of your faith works patience. 4, but let patience have a perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. So now here's my question. We all know that anyone who is prideful can never be patient. A prideful person will lack patience. Why? Because instead of them to be meek and humble to fear Yahuwah, the pride in them will make them to be hasty to just speak and attack words. The scripture itself says we should allow patience do a perfect work. Why can't we allow patience run through us? Why are we giving ourselves up to pride? Let's go to the book of Uzziah, chapter 7. The book of Uzziah. Uzziah, chapter 7. And I'll take verse 10. And it says, and the pride of Yasharel testifies to his face, and they do not return to Eliyahu Elohim, nor seek him for all this. Can you see that? It says that the pride of Yashareel testifies to his face, and they do not return to Eliyahu. Why is that actually happening? Because they allow pride set in. And when that pride sets in, is that same pride that will stand to testify against you. Because pride actually is like you having a new master. You can never serve Yah and serve pride. It's not possible. It's either you serve Yahuwah or you leave Yahuwah and you serve pride. The book of Enoch. Enoch chapter 6. Book of Enoch chapter 6. And I'll take verse 11. And it says, then shall wisdom be given to the elect, all of whom shall live, and not again transgress by impiety or pride, but shall humble themselves, possessing prudence, and shall not repeat transgression. Why do you think that particular passage talk about those that do not transgress again through impiety or pride? Why is it pride? Because for the fact that now you are waking, pride is that particular thing that can be sent through Satan to bring you down. If Satan can see that, yes, you have overcome all the old physical temptation that he brought to you, what he will do next is to see how he can strike through pride.